Hello friends, so this video is going to be very interesting because I'm going to answer very important questions in this video, like how to transfer the eSIM, when to transfer your physical SIM, whether this transfer WhatsApp chats, whether it transfers photos and videos from your old iPhone to new iPhone, whether it transfers email apps and email accounts, whether it remembers the social media logins, how to pair your Apple Watch, etc. So this video will give you idea what are the things you need to consider to transfer everything from your old iPhone to new iPhone 12 or 12 Pro. And we are not using iTunes or iCloud backup here. If you want to use iTunes and iCloud, there is a separate tutorial in the cards as well as in the description below. You can check out that tutorial. So now let's begin, and the first thing you want to do is press this power button to turn the display on after you unbox your iPhone. So you should be on this screen before you begin. Now if you already set up your iPhone, you need to factory reset it manually to start this procedure again. So firstly, swipe up from the bottom of the screen, select the language. Now select your country or region. Now this quick start method will set up everything automatically. No iTunes or iCloud needed. So read the instructions before you begin. Basically, you need to have Bluetooth turned on your old iPhone. So this is our iPhone XS which we are using to transfer the data. Now this is the pop-up you should get on your old iPhone to start this transfer process. Here you want to hit this continue button. Now hold your old iPhone camera over your new iPhone to scan the image. Now it has started transferring the data. Now you want to enter old iPhone lock screen passcode on your new iPhone. This will also become the passcode of your new iPhone. Now this should start setting up the iPhone, and this is gonna take some time, so you wanna keep both the iPhones next to each other and let it complete the transfer. Now you want to set up the Face ID on your new iPhone. So hit continue and set up Face ID. Face ID is set up, let's hit continue. Now this is interesting, watch this carefully. You have got two options here. First is you can transfer all your data from old iPhone to this new iPhone. And the second option is iPhone will download all your data from iCloud, like photos, videos, notes, etc. in the background if you have stored them on the iCloud. You can choose any of the options, but I would prefer to transfer all the data from old iPhone to this new iPhone, even though it's gonna take more time. So let's choose this option, transfer from iPhone. Now select agree, confirm agree. Now the settings are being copied from your old iPhone, so let's hit continue. Hit continue again. iMessage and FaceTime, hit continue. Now it is asking if you want to pair your Apple Watch with this new iPhone. Yes, we want to do that. So let's say continue. I'll share more information about this Apple Watch later. Now you can set up Siri if you want to. I'll set up later in settings. Improve Siri and dictation. I'll select not now. App analytics. I'll select don't share. Now this is very important guys. The iOS version on my new iPhone is older than iOS version on my old iPhone. So Apple is asking me to update iOS version on my new iPhone so that it can transfer the data. So if you also have the same case, you want to select download and install. Enter lock screen passcode, agree to the terms and conditions. Now allow your new iPhone to update the iOS version. Wait until the process is complete. Meanwhile, you should go ahead and connect both the iPhones to power source using lightning connector. Now new iPhone is updated with latest iOS and it is reconnecting with my old iPhone. And now it is preparing to transfer the data. Now as you can see, it is showing the transfer status and time remaining. You should keep both the iPhones connected to power source and next to each other. Now once it is completed, you should see this screen. Unlock your iPhone and it should say restore completed. It is still downloading apps and data in the background, so keep that in mind, and now go ahead and hit continue. For app analytics, I'll select don't share. And here is the welcome screen. And when you swipe up, you can see that it is the exact replica of our old iPhone. old iPhone still shows the status of transferring data, but it has actually completed the transfer. I had to cancel that pop-up manually because it was still there even if my new iPhone was ready to use. So I knew it was a bug and everything was already transferred on my new iPhone. Now this is the exact replica of my old iPhone. It is still downloading the apps in the background, but it has copied all the data from my old iPhone. All photos and videos from camera roll are also transferred. Now what you want to do is go ahead and transfer the physical SIM card from your old iPhone to your new iPhone. Let's use the SIM ejector tool you received with your new iPhone and remove the SIM card. So this is the SIM card we will transfer. Remove the SIM tray of your new iPhone, place the card on the SIM tray properly and then insert into new iPhone. Now it should find the network automatically. Your SIM is now active on your new iPhone. Now let's check out the very important thing, whether it has transferred all the WhatsApp chats or not. See, if you're living in Asian countries, you know how important this WhatsApp is. And apart from the privacy policies that WhatsApp has released recently, we already have used WhatsApp for several years and we have a lot of data on it. So we don't want to lose that data. So let's see if that data has been transferred from old iPhone to new iPhone. So let's open the WhatsApp. It is asking for mobile number verification. And after verifying mobile number, I can see that all the messages, photos, videos, everything is transferred from old iPhone to new iPhone. No issues at all. But remember that WhatsApp will deactivate on your old iPhone immediately. So you can use WhatsApp only on your new iPhone now. Now another important question here is eSIM. As you can see, I could transfer only my physical SIM during this process. eSIM is not transferred, so you want to do it on your own. So how did I transfer my eSIM? See, every cellular network provider has their own way of adding eSIM to your iPhone. So you should know how to do it for your carrier. In my case, I simply had to go to cellular plan section on my old iPhone, hit remove cellular plan, confirm removal, again confirm removal, and then this removed the eSIM from my old iPhone. Now, on my new iPhone, I went to cellular section in settings and chose add cellular plan option. Now, I scanned the QR code given by my cellular network and it simply added the eSIM profile to my new iPhone. Then I had to just set up preferences for eSIM. Then they sent me SMS. I had to download a profile from their website and install it to start using the eSIM services on my new iPhone. And that was all. So this method may or may not be similar with your cellular network provider. So go ahead and check with your service provider and then you start resetting or transferring data from your old iPhone to new iPhone. And if you're expecting any important calls or messages on your eSIM, I would recommend to do this transfer process on weekends. And I also set up my WhatsApp business account using the eSIM. And all the messages, photos, videos, everything was transferred. So no issues again. Now talking about the social media apps, all apps were already signed in. Facebook, Insta, Twitter. I didn't have to go and sign in again. So you don't need to remember usernames and passwords for these social media apps. However, if you talk about the Google apps like YouTube, Gmail, Authenticator, they were not signed in. If Google Authenticator is the only way for two-factor authentication for your Google account, you will be stuck in a loop and you won't be able to log into your Google account. So this is a big issue if you don't know the credentials and keep this in mind before you reset your iPhone. Now talking about email apps, Spark, Yahoo and Apple Mail, all these apps were signed in with all the existing email accounts. But the Gmail app, being a Google product, was not signed in with the account. Now if you talk about the apps that store data on iPhone like Documents app, the data for this app was successfully transferred. All files were transferred, no issues. However, there is one more similar app called Player Extreme for media consumption. The data inside this app was not transferred. Reason, I don't know, but you have to be careful if you have important data stored on these type of applications. So I would suggest not to sell your old iPhone until you're confident enough that everything is transferred from old iPhone to new iPhone. Many people sell their old iPhone before they purchase the new one. Don't do that. Keep your old iPhone with you for a couple of days, and once you are sure enough that everything has been transferred from your old iPhone to new iPhone, you can go ahead and sell your old iPhone. Now finally, the Apple Watch pairing. My Apple Watch did not pair with the new iPhone. It was still paired with my old iPhone. When I saw Apple Watch app on my new iPhone, it was still asking me to pair it manually. Reason is very simple here. You need to keep your Apple Watch next to your new iPhone when it is transferring the data. I did not do that, so I had to do it manually. Doing it manually is also very easy. New video is coming soon, so stay tuned for that. And that's all for today. That's how you can transfer everything from your old iPhone to new iPhone 12 or 12 Pro. If you have any specific questions, ask me down in the comment section below. Consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next one.